Okay, we'll start off with a little bit of a warm up. So we're just going to put arms up and bringing elbows down, squeezing your elbows back together. And then arms in front, squeezing elbows back. And we'll put arms out and twist. And hugging arms out, squeezing into your chest, just hugging in and then swapping the arm that you put on top. Okay, and then we're just going to jog on the spot for about 5 seconds. And then taking one leg up and around, and then jogging. And then other leg around. Starting to get heart rate up a little bit, and also opening up into your hips. Hi Gemma.
Hiya. Sorry,
I'm okay, we're just warming up. Okay, then come onto your hands and knees. And from here, just push your stomach towards the floor, shoulders back, just pushing your chest forwards. And then pushing back the ceiling, shoulder blades. Pushing apart, looking towards your knees. And then just moving between the two. Okay, coming up onto one knee, just going to tuck tailbone under, so you can feel a stretch along the back hip, and then raising arms forward, and then come back, trying to find a stretch here, try not to arch your back. Okay, swapping onto the other leg, same on the other side. Okay, and then standing up, you're taking feet about hip width apart. Just going to reach down, touch your toes, you can bend your legs a little bit. So from here, I want you to feel a stretch in the back of your legs. And then holding onto your toes, bringing your knees out wide, kind of coming to a low squat. See if you can keep your heels down. You might need to adjust your legs slightly. And then reaching up, stretching into your legs again. And then bringing knees down. I've actually got a hold of my leg in, so it's a bad one. Stretching into back to your legs again. So reach your palm up. And then bending your legs. Stretching into your squat. Again. Okay, so we'll get started now. So we've got the first set of 4 exercises. Grabbing your weight. And so if you haven't been to the session before, we're doing 40 seconds of each exercise with 20 second rest in between. And then, so the first exercise you're going to do is with your chair. You can either squat down, tap, thumb on the chair and back up, or taking one foot off, you're going to bend the foot down and then standing up. Do one leg on the first round, then the other leg on the second round. Second exercise, you're taking your weight into one hand. You'll be able to go quite heavy with this one. Little bend in the knees, feet about hip width apart. Keep your shoulders back and down. And then from here, reaching down, and then bringing hips forward. Keeping the weight in the one arm, and that just makes you slightly more unstable, so it puts more pressure on your core. So I want you to try and keep your shoulders level. Keep your core tight. And then standing up. Third exercise. So here, I want you to crouch down. Take one leg out. Bring that in. So stand. If you want to progress this burpees, you can, but just really be careful with your form, keep your core tight. So back again, down, jumping back, we're gonna jump in and stand. And then fourth exercise, taking your weight again. So we're gonna squat down here, bring the weight up to your shoulder, press up to the ceiling. Go back to here, some swapping, squatting down, up to your shoulder, pressing up, back down. Okay, so start the timer. So starting off with your weight held at your chest. So on one leg, ideally, just make sure you check that the chair is there. So sitting down, keep it really controlled on the upward motion and down. You can have both feet on the floor if you need to. Just keep stomach pulled in tight. And ideally breathing out as you stand up. Got 10 seconds left on this leg. Okay, next exercise, so we're coming onto our suitcase deadlifts. So weight in one hand, feet about hip width apart, a little bend in the knees. On this one, we're bending at the hips, so it's not quite a squat. So off you go. Bearing down, keep the weight close to your shins. And then standing up. You want to feel a stretch in the backs of your legs. Not quite feeling that, so lean back a little bit more. And breathe it out as you stand up. Remember to think what arm you're on now, because we'll be swapping over after. Okay, weight down now. So we're going on to our either the burpees or the variation. So you come into a crouch, one foot out, back there, really strong full plank here, and then back up. Or you can jump, so off you go. So down. And then. So really conscious of your technique. Keep that back strong, keep your stomach pulled in tight. Okay, now to our squat with our press. Grabbing your weight. Going in 3 seconds. Squatting down. Weight to your shoulder. Pressing up. And swapping to the other arm. Squatting down. Shoulder. Alternating each time. Seconds left. Okay, 5 seconds to go. Okay, now back to the chair. So we've got a single leg squat, but on the other leg this time. Hopefully you remember which one you're on. So going in 3 seconds, letting leg raise, sitting back, controlling the downwards and the upward motion, take it nice and slow. Yeah. and 10 seconds to go. And one more, I think. Okay, now going back to the suitcase deadlift with the weight in your other hand. So you're getting set, feet slight hip width apart, the weight stays in your heels as you go back. So really making an effort to keep shoulders level. Okay, 20 seconds left. And 10 seconds to go. Three, two, one. Okay, onto our burpees or stepping out. Okay, up to you going in 10 seconds. Time five. Off we go. All right, a second out. Make sure you swap legs that you're going out and in on. Or jump in. Really good. Do some good ones. Well done. 5 seconds left. Okay, and we're going back to our squats with our shoulder press. So feet just over hip width apart, two toes out slightly, if that helps you get your knees out. Going in 3 seconds. Here we go, so squatting down, up to shoulder and press, swapping arms. Breathing out as you press. Just over halfway. And 5 seconds left. Okay, and now we've got the second set of exercises. So you're gonna stay working our legs at the moment. You're gonna take your weight held at your chest. From here, we're doing reverse lunges. So taking one foot back and then up, and we're gonna swap legs to the other side and up. So you can lean forward slightly. I want you to keep the weight in your front heel as you go down. Second exercise, weight down and pulling onto your chair. And from here, bending down, back up. Only go as far as you feel comfortable because you might be limited on your flexibility in the front of your shoulders, but you'll still be getting a workout, so just be careful on that one. So third exercise, picking up your weight again. From here, keeping the weight in our heels, feet slight hip width apart, arms going backwards, stomach pulled in. And from here, rowing back and alternating each time. Keep core in tight. And then fourth exercise, mountain climbers. So you can either do this, hand on the chair here, bringing one knee in and then the other, or on the floor, nice and slow, really squeezing, keeping shoulders in line with wrists or slightly over, and then trying to keep your bum down. So I'll start the timer, starting with our reverse lunges, going in just over 5 seconds. Okay, off we go. So keeping the weight in that front heel. If you do struggle with your knees or your mobility, you can just do lunges here. Doesn't matter how far you can go. And just swap legs each time. Make sure the knees stay in line with your feet. Okay, So 10 seconds to go. Really good. And 3 seconds. Okay, weight down. Going to our tricep dips. So hands on the chair, either facing forward, or you might turn slightly out depending on the width of your chair. Going down slightly, doesn't matter how far you can go. Moving out as you press up. Of course, with more weight you put on your hands, the harder it is. And take your feet out slightly. Ten seconds to go. Last 3 seconds. Okay, grabbing your weight. And then feet apart. So bending, hinging your hips slightly. Stomach, face pulled in, ribs down. And then rowing back. The weight's sort of coming towards your hips as well, so you're not just bending up to your armpit, bringing that elbow back. Be nice. Got 20 seconds left. Keep pouring tight. Make it a full body exercise. 10 seconds left. 3 seconds to go. Okay, weight down. So now onto mountain climbers, either with your hands on the chair. Okay, so bring your legs in, one at a time. Re-squeeze into your stomach as you do it. Keep legs squeezed, arms locked out. And keep your neck in line with your spine because you're looking just in front of your hands. Make it underneath yourself. 20 seconds to go. Well done. Just over 10 seconds. And you can relax back to lunges now, so reverse lunges. Weight at your chest if you can. Going in 3 seconds. And now, back up. Driving through that front heel as you stand. That's halfway. Keep going. Ten seconds left. Three seconds. Okay, weight down, back to our tricep dips. Good. 5 seconds. Off we go. Smarter, 30 seconds to go. That's halfway. And just under 10 seconds. 3 seconds to go. Okay, we're going back to our single arm row, which we did one side before, as you swap to the other side. If you're alternating, we're doing the same. Going in 5 seconds. bend. Going back. Really focus on feeling it into your midsection in your back. Seconds to go. Three, two, one. Okay, weight down. Back to our mountain climbers, so on the chair or on the floor. And do it on the floor if you can. This will put too much pressure on your wrists. Take it up onto the chair. Last 40 seconds here. Keep nice and strong, don't let your bum come up or drop your hips. Well, 5 seconds to go. Okay, then coming onto your back, so you can either stay on your forearms, bring one leg out, and then the other, really focus, staying on pulling the stomach muscles in tight, or here, bring it up and lowering back down. Hello, feet down, and then onto your hands and knees. You're either holding into a knee hover, and if you need to come down for like the 40 seconds, that's fine, just join back in as soon as you can. Or threading your leg through, so from here, leg through, opposite arm off, and then swapping to the other side. Really nice. 20 seconds left. Well done. 5 seconds left. Okay, coming back onto your back for your heels on the chair. On the floor, you need to. Going in 3 seconds. Pull the glutes up first. I do want to breathe out as you press up. To your feet. Going in 3 seconds. Keep your stomach pulled in. Nice. See some good ones. Keep neck long in line with spine. 50 seconds to go. And 10 seconds left. Three, two, one. Okay, coming onto your back. So either on your forearms, taking one leg out, then the other, or we've got our knee set. Going in 3 seconds. One leg out. The other. Okay, almost halfway. Seconds left. And 5 seconds to go. Okay, and then onto our knee hover and threading through our legs if you can. Going in 5 seconds. We go, so hold it here if you can, then if you want to, threading that leg through, you're halfway. Okay, then finally, we're coming over to a wall or a door, or you can hold it here in a squat. We're going to do a wall sit, so you can have a weight held in your legs or in your chest if you need to. Coming down here, we're going to hold it 40 seconds. Off we go. So get your upper legs parallel, so horizontal. Holding it here. Then keep stomach pulled in so your lower back stays against the wall. If you do need to stand up, shake your legs around, that's fine. Just join back in when you can. So over halfway. We've got 10 seconds left. And 5, 4, 3, two, one, stand up. Next up, we've got side plank. So choose your starting side. So from here, we've got a couple of variations. As long as your shoulders in line with your elbow, so you're coming onto your knee. Or if you can, or you can progress it, you've got one leg out, or both legs onto your feet. So I'll start the timer. Nice, so we're going to do 40 seconds. Imagine your body's between two panes of glass. Keeping nice line across here and neck long in line with spine if you can. Those hips high. Squeeze your legs together. Squeeze your glutes. Squeeze stomach muscles. Okay, you've got 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lowering down. Coming onto the other side now, exactly the same. So choose whichever version you went, you do on the other side, do the same on this side. Okay, when you're ready, off we go. So check your line, elbow, shoulders, up. 10 seconds go. Halfway, is squeeze ankles together, knees together, thighs together, squeeze your glute muscles, keep those hips pushed high, 10 seconds left. Three, two, one, lowering down. Okay, then we're going to come down to a lying on your back position. Stretch your arms up above your head. Legs out long, point your toes. Sort of stretch your body as long as you can. And then we're going to hug knees into your chest and circle your knees around one way a few times. And then circle the other way. And I want you to keep hold of your right knee, so I might be mirrored on this, but just trying to listen, so left leg out straight. And then I'm gonna take hold of your right knee in your left hand, and gently twist over the left hand side. Right arm reaches out, so you can look over at your fingertips, so you're getting a nice stretch into your back. Into your core. Breathe nice and deeply. Relaxing bit. Go onto your back again, hugging both knees into your chest. This time, take your right leg, reach out straight. Take hold of your left knee with your right hand, and then gently pull that left knee over to the right hand side. Left hand reaches out, go over your fingertips. Okay, Inhaling the roll onto your stomach. You place your hands just directly into your armpits, next to your chest. And from here, we're gently pushing up. Doesn't matter how high you can go, you just want to open up into your back a little bit. We're not compressing the spine, keeping the spine nice and long. And lowering down. Just keep moving through this one. Once more, pushing up. And lowering down. Then we're going to come up, then we're going to come onto hands and knees. Taking your knees out wide. Hands stay down, you sit back towards your heels, so you should feel a stretch into your hips, into your inner thighs, potentially beneath your glutes. Reach arms forwards. Place your head down on the floor. You can, I better not sweating off it. Just relaxing there, nice deep breath. Right, then coming into a seated position. We're gonna reach one leg out straight. The sole of your other foot comes to your inner thigh. So from here, get comfortable and splash your butt. Your bum. We're gonna reach up, take a big breath in, and then breathe out, keeping your back nice and long. You're gonna try and fold down that straight leg. Then you can relax and bend your back a little bit, height if you want to. Try and feel a stretch into the back of your upper leg. On every out breath, see if you can go a little bit further. And then out to the other side, so other leg out straight. Sole of your foot to your inner thigh. You reach up, take a big breath in. And then breathe out, fold down. Keep breathing nice and deeply. Okay, coming up onto your knees. From here, I want you to take your hands clasped together, pushing your shoulder blades apart. And then hands behind your back. If you can, clasp hands. It might be easier to clasp elbows. If you can't, bring your shoulder blades together so you're stretching into the front of your chest. And bring your hands away from your back if you can. And from here, I want you to drop one ear to one shoulder, the other. A bit of a neck stretch as well. Okay, one arm across your chest, other hand into your elbow, gently push in. Try to feel a stretch along the outside of your shoulder. And then going to the other side, the other arm reaches across, hand to elbow. Okay, we'll do last arm stretch, so your hand comes to opposite shoulder. Another hand comes to your elbow, gently pushing that hand a little bit down your back. Okay, onto the other side, the other hand over, hand to elbow, gently down. We'll feel the stretch on the outside of your arm. Great, and standing up, we'll do a calf stretch, so one leg in front of the other, other leg back, pushing your heel down towards the floor. You want to try and find a stretch in the back of your lower leg. It can help if you lean on something sometimes, you can't quite find it. Thanks, Laura. Okay, popping onto the other leg. The leg back. And then finally, we'll do a quad stretch. So standing onto one foot, take hold of your one ankle, bringing the knees together, pushing the hip on the side of that bent leg forwards. Okay. Okay, and swapping on to the other leg. Knees together, pushing hip forwards. You start to feel the stretch in your hip or your upper leg, depending on where's tightest. And there we go, you're done. Well done, everyone.